Dear Tommy, thank you for submitting your demo to... We appreciate the time and effort you put into creating and sharing your music with us. After careful consideration, we want to inform you that...
Maybe we'll go to the Totally Guitar Book, eh? It's helped me many a time escape a writer's block. What do you think of that? It's got that great G minor modulation. I do love this idea. Already know I'm gonna write a banger for this. Without a doubt, going on the EP for sure. I did this other one, it's number 10. I don't know. My concern is that it sounds a little bit pop, like it's too cute or something. This just kind of sounds like Sixpence None the Richer or something. I don't know. I have to think about this one. Doubt hath crept in to thy mind.
What it prizes above all else is something called authenticity. And when capital C country moves into the glitzy, gaudy world of capital P pop music, well, that can shake things up a bit.
Hey, just another one. I'll just play you a bit of it and then I'll ask you the question, all right? Do you think that could be turned into a country song?
It is a country song.
Really, you think?
No.
I'm thinking it might be time to consult the oracles.
Understanding how you feel in the face of other voices without second guessing yourself is probably the single most important thing to practice.
You know what? Let's have a go. Just give it a real red hot crack, eh?
Are you proud of how it all turned out? Did you ever want to let me know?
It's too high. We need to bounce this out, make it lower in pitch.
I keep them bloody blue. I get them out when I remember who I am to you and flipping that and back who holding this.
What is a feeling of nostalgia? What does that mean?
Oh.
Ooh, could be this though.
I've been away too long, I wanna go back. They call it homesick, is there a cure for that?
We're doing it. That's the idea.
I've been away too long, I think I'll go back. I think I'm homesick, is there any cure for that? Cause I wanna go back.
homesick. I think it might be this. I think we're just in the wrong key, which is annoying. It means I've got to re-record everything again in the proper key. Yeah, it's this. It's this. It is. It is the homesick thing too. We're doing it. All right, so I'm just listening back to the homesick thing we did earlier, and I'm already over it. I think I'm going to try and do something different. I just think it's naff. This kind of a fucking setup. No. Don't. No. How weird is this? I was just about to call it a night, so I'd had enough of this fucking song. And out of nowhere, this melody pops into my head. Sounds amazing. I'll bet you with this new idea, I'll bet you I find some really good harmony notes straight away. Yeah, was right about the harmonies. Hang on, I'll give you the lesson. Sounds mean. What do we think? Slow down the night? It's a good start anyway. It's not a start, it's a middle, because we started with something else and now we're on to something completely different, but I'm liking where this is going more than that other idea I spent all day on. Pursue this a bit further. Slow down the night sounds dumb, because you can't do that. You cannot stop time. You can go back in time, freeze time. Slow down the night, go back in time. Try this back in time thing. I wish that I could go back in time. I wish I could go back in time. How's it pull not to make you mine? Woo! That might be the chorus. That's the birth of a chorus. Hindsight's 2020. Sometimes I think that, well, I start to wonder what. Fuck. Sometimes I think that if we had never split, maybe I'd be the one smiling in her family pics. Now we're on it. You'd be my woman and I'd be your man, but I guess it didn't go to plan. Oh shit. Alright. That'll be a wrap on today, I reckon. We got some good stuff. I'm very pleased. Alright, I guess it's time for a little bit of an update, because I have reached a first draft. These are some of the lyrics. Here's what the arrangement looks like, the structure. What else? Oh, so the old melody that I was really hung up on, I found a little roll for that as well. It can just be a guitar riff. I've got three other songs at the moment. I've just kind of bounced them out, just in the process of listening back to them, thinking, do I want to make any changes? Yeah, we'll go from there. We'll see what happens with this one. You know what? I've been listening and I'm starting to have this doubt where I think the lyrics are sounding a little bit vague. Like it doesn't have a strong enough theme for the song. I'm not happy with the line, you'd be my woman and I'd be your man, but I guess it didn't go to plan. That's just kind of a very generic sort of lyric. I'm just trying to tell more of a story. That line says, before you started your life with some other guy, I reckon I could do something there. And then maybe even the second verse. Although I really love it, it could maybe just tell more of a story about why we split. All right, you know what? We're changing them. We're doing it. I'm committing. It's gonna suck. It's gonna take a lot of brain power. But it's gotta be done. Get the Kelpie on, we'll make a cup of tea and we'll get into it. A man regrets that he didn't marry his ex. She dumped him because he wouldn't commit. That's what the song is about.
Going back in time, maybe I can make it work a second time around.
I've been trying so hard to rhyme something with harm that relates to this song, and I think I've finally found it. We're on ChatGPT. Better half. Harm half. I think this is the rhyme. Ooh, that could be it. Well, some other guy, and I mean him no harm, but I know I'd be a better half. We're done. We are done.
Hidden pigs. It's some other guy, and I made him no harm. But I know I'd be better off.
Yay, me. Finished another one. Well, I guess that's the end of that.
I've got some vocals back.
Yes.
Sometimes I think that if we had never split, maybe I'd be the one smiling in them wedding pics.
I reckon we can work with these.
Mean him no harm, but I know I'd be a better half. I wish that I could go back in time.
Sending out the song right now to an A&R at Big Loud. This is what it reads. And now we wait.
All right. So, woke up this morning, saw that I had an email in my inbox from the A&R from the label. I've got a reply. I'm nervous. I'm going to read it right now. Oh, fuck. Okay, here we go. Dear Tommy, thank you for submitting your demo to... We appreciate the time and effort you put into creating and sharing your music with us. After careful consideration, we... regret to inform you that we will not be moving forward with your submission at this time. While we believe that your music shows promise, we receive many submissions on a regular basis and can only sign a limited number of artists. We encourage you to continue pursuing your music career and wish you all the best in your future endeavors. While we cannot offer specific feedback on your submission, we encourage you to keep refining your sound and developing your skills as a musician. Thank you again for considering as a potential partner in your music career. Sincerely, X. Well, fuck, that's not the answer that I wanted to hear. But you know what? It's to be expected. You know, I've been doing this songwriting game now for years and years, and I've
I've never had any interest from any major labels or any even independent labels, to be honest. I just do this for the love of it. For me, songwriting really is a game that I love, and it really is about the journey of writing a song and feeling the thrill when you're able to complete it, when you find the last little line that fits and creates the lyric. It would be a real bonus if people wanted to cut the tracks and distribute them and, you know, sign them to major labels, but for right now, I'm happy doing this as a hobby. I'm happy just making music here at home where there's no pressure of, you know, executives and A&Rs and you know, getting streams and this and that. So who knows? One day I might get there, but for now, you got to remember to do it for the love of the game, yeah? And that's all I have to say about that. If you've made it this far into this video, you are a dead set bloody legend. You saw me write this song in real time. And if you want to know how I really did it, I followed a few key principles that are outlined in this recent video I made called How to Write a Song Like Morgan Wallen. So if you're interested in writing singer-songwriter pop that's really catchy and simple, I suggest you check that out. Guys, just remember, it's a long way to the top if you want to rock and roll. So I guess with that, I'll see you guys in the next one. That's it.